Hi, welcome to one more Forest Drops video. Today, we are going to talk about environmental benefits of alfalfa introduction into forage systems. My name is Lilian Silva. I work as a postdoc fellow at Auburn University at the Animal Science Department. So let's get started. Just quickly, I'll touch on what ecosystem services are. And they are defined as the benefits people obtain from ecosystems. And some examples are, for example, food and clothing and rural tourism, which has been increasing over the last years. So management practices on forage systems can improve ecosystem service delivery. And incorporation of legumes is one of them because it decreases the use of chemical nitrogen fertilizer and while improving forage yields and quality. Alfalfa, just quickly touching on this because we have another video about alfalfa in this channel. So if you like, please go to the Forage Drops and check that video. After you are done with this one. So just briefly, alfalfa is a perennial legume with high yields and quality that requires more intensive management and high level skills to manage alfalfa production. It is generally used as hay, haylage or baleage and grazed. In the southern U.S., there has been challenges with scent persistence due to prolonged droughts, pest and disease pressure, and competition with warm season species. So when we are talking about nitrogen fixation, we are basically saying that legumes are able to capture nitrogen from the atmosphere and convert on compounds that the plant root systems are able to consume and use to grow. So this happens because of a symbiotic association that legumes have with rhizobium bacteria, which is a soil bacteria that forms nodules in the roots. These bacteria can convert inaccessible nitrogen from the air to forms that the plants are able to use. Then the nitrogen becomes available not only for the legumes, but also for neighbor plants, which can be grasses when you have legumes in mixture with grasses. But the nitrogen can also remain on soil, which is which will be available for later crop if you're doing rotation, or just improve the soil fertility through incorporation of nitrogen there. And one of the main services that grasslands provide is nutrient cycling, especially when you have animals on grazing the pastures. So input of nitrogen increases forage quality and quantity and improves diet quality, reflecting on animal performance. Generally, animals are able to retain around 20 or 30% of nutrients. And what they are not able to retain, they just excrete through urine and feces. So all that amount are deposited throughout the area, throughout the pasture where they are grazing or they are staying on. So basically, we have plants doing photosynthesis. So this box represents this. Then, so the plants are doing photosynthesis and are growing. They are going to be consumed by the animals. And the animals are able to return some of this creta. So they are going to be inputting nutrients back to the system, but also these animals are providing milk and meat, which are going to be take off farm to be sold somewhere else. And we also have the rural tourism generally in rural areas, and the nitrogen fixation through by legumes is a portion of that system, because we'll be providing nitrogen to the grass to grow. Another point that this improved soil fertility, soil quality will also contribute is to increase soil organic matter over time. So soil organic matter is important to the soil because it will allow to retain nutrients for the plants to be able to consume them, but also it is important for water infiltration, water holding capacity, improving soil fertility, and is a pool of nutrients, but also it can hold the soil compaction back to some extent. Alfalfa can also improve the diversity of the pasture, and one of the ways that it does, it's by increasing pollinators and wildlife in those areas. So alfalfa stands can serve as habitat, shelter, and food for many animals and beneficial insects. And because there's a general concern with decrease of pollinators worldwide, these are a good source to increase diversity and bring pollinators back to some regions. And in US, around approximately 1/3 of honey comes from alfalfa stands. So this is all for today. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Reach out with questions by our Facebook page or by this email on the screen. If you have any questions, thank you so much for joining us today, and please subscribe to our YouTube page today. Thank you.